No important art auction would be complete without a beautiful painting by Sir John Lavery, and here we have the very striking portrait of Lady Parmoor. This portrait was in the family collection of Lord and Lady Parmoor and was also exhibited in London's Royal Academy in 1920. To put this piece in context, by 1918 we saw the cessation of hostilities on the Western Front, and Sir John Lavery, as the official war artist, was still very much in demand. He had yet to complete a very large commission depicting the surrender of the German Navy and was also called to northern France to record depots and hospitals before they were dismantled and also to depict the work of the women behind the lines. So it wasn't until February 1919, after his holiday in the Bay of Tunis, that his Cromwell Road studio in London really sprung back into action. It was during this year that he painted a portrait of one Marion Emily Ellis, later to become the second Baroness Parmoor. It was her husband, the Baron Parmoor, that commissioned the portrait. They were married in the July of that year, and it was likely that the portrait was commissioned as a wedding present to the new bride. Now, no social butterfly was Lady Parmoor. She was a very, very prominent figure in the day. Her husband and herself were staunch anti-war liberals, and indeed Lady Parmoor was very nearly imprisoned for her convictions. She spoke out against conscription, among other very high-profile topics of the day. There's no doubt that Lady Parmoor and Lavery would have talked so much about the war and about Lavery's involvement as a war artist, but I think Lavery's main concern at the present time was how to depict this very important sitter in terms of the form and the composition. He chose a 30 by 25 inch canvas, which he felt was the appropriate size to depict the sitter in half length. It always worked very well for him. In terms of the overall tone, it was a familiar one that we had seen in the past and that he was now revisiting. It shows the sitter in the dark blues and blacks, but relieved with this brown, luxurious fur stole. A harmony in brown, if you like, as in the artist's words. It's an overall composition that we saw him working in the late 1800s and also in the early 1900s, where he depicted his own wife, Lady Lavery, in the beautiful fur stole. And that painting is actually in Dublin City Gallery, the Hugh Lane. And Lavery felt that the aspect of the fur stole softened the picture, drew the eye to the important sitter being Lady Parmoor. And at this stage, Lady Parmoor was actually very much involved in fighting famine in post-war Europe and post-revolutionary Russia. She led the YWCA and also the International Women's League for Peace and Freedom. And in her 70s, after a long and very active career, she was speaking out against the use of nuclear weapons. So a formidable sitter, one of Lavery's most serious sitters, as I said, not a social butterfly, a very historically important figure, beautifully depicted, and at an estimate of 30 to 50,000 euro, I feel it's a very, very important piece and a very attractive piece in our forthcoming auction.